Peter Doocy's questions, and WH Press Sec Karine Jean-Pierre's answers encapsulate the intense ideological and political struggle defining modern American politics. Doocy's inquiries shed light on leadership and national security concerns, while Jean-Pierre's responses often appear inadequate in addressing these pressing issues. This dynamic highlights the administration's involvement, or lack thereof, in addressing these critical matters.
A different topic. Russia and China are teaming up in the skies near Alaska for the first time ever. Are you getting a sense yet, based on everything that's been going on, that some of America's enemies might be looking at what's happening here and think there's nobody in charge?
So let me just say this. There is very much someone in charge. The president is the president until the end of his term. So that statement is certainly false. And we have seen the president bring together our allies and partners. He reinvigorated NATO. He got more than 50 countries behind Ukraine to make sure that they were able to defend themselves against Putin. He stood up to Putin, and he's done a lot more. And now, right now, as we're speaking, I believe it's still happening. The president is having a bilateral conversation meeting with the prime minister of Israel. So who, by the way, the prime minister of Israel thanked the president for the work that he's been able to do in helping to make sure that Israel is able to have an ironclad security. Right. And so that's that. But let me be clear. I want to actually address the basis of your question outside of saying there's no leadership. Our Department of Defense did not see this activity in Alaska Air Defense Identification Zone as a threat. North American Aerospace Defense Command, NORAD, continues to monitor PRC and Russian activity near North America and to meet presence with presence. U.S. and Canadian aircraft detected, tracked, and intercepted the Russian and PRC aircraft. And more broadly, the U.S. remains concerned about the PRC and Russian collaboration across all instruments of national power that do not promote global stability and security, not just in the Arctic, but the president. If anything, if you look at his foreign policy objectives and what he's been able to do and what the last administration did, the last administration ruined our relationships with our partners and allies. This president had to fix that and make sure that we actually mended our relationship with our partners and allies. And that's what we've been able to do. And a perfect example is what we're seeing with Ukraine being able to defend itself against Russia's aggression. Okay.
Doocy's probing questions about Jean-Pierre reflect concerns over the perceived ineffectiveness of the current administration's leadership. Many in the public resonate with Doocy's argument that America's adversaries might see the administration as weak or disorganized. Jean-Pierre's evasive and overly focused defense of past actions rather than addressing current threats only amplifies this perception. The interactions between Doocy and Jean-Pierre center on themes of authenticity, responsibility, and the search for meaning. Doocy's questions challenge the administration's leadership and the genuineness of its decision-making processes. In contrast, Jean-Pierre's responses are scrutinized for their depth and sincerity, determining whether they genuinely address the nation's security concerns or merely attempt to deflect criticism. Doocy's inquiries aim to disrupt the administration's narrative of effective leadership, prompting a reevaluation of potential threats, such as the collaboration between Russia and China. Jean-Pierre's tactic of highlighting past successes while avoiding criticisms of previous administrations seems an effort to reassure supporters of the administration's competence, thereby restoring cognitive consensus. Public reactions to these exchanges are likely to be polarized. Supporters of the administration may view Jean-Pierre's responses as a robust defense of President Joe Biden's leadership and diplomatic achievements. Conversely, critics might see her replies as insufficient and evasive, further reinforcing the perception of ineffective leadership.